A Guide to Improving Your Marriage. This information is not presented by a medical practitioner and is for educational and informational purposes only. The content is not intended to be a substitute for professional medical advice, diagnosis, or treatment. Always seek the advice of your physician or other qualified healthcare provider with any questions you may have regarding a medical condition. Never disregard professional medical advice or delay in seeking it because of something you have read or heard. Are you feeling unfulfilled in your marriage? Do you feel that the passion and attraction are barely there or missing altogether? The absence of the feelings we want to feel with our spouse can often lead to unhappiness and often conflict. Just because you are arguing all of the time doesn't mean that you are hopeless. You are missing the essential components that make up a happy marriage. The fact that you are reading this means that you have a wealth of underlying emotion just waiting to be unleashed into your marriage. Read on or listen on to find out how you can not only improve your marriage, but you can also enjoy having one of the best and most enviable relationships today. Is your marriage a companionship or a love affair? Every marriage is just like any relationship. They have their ups and downs, agreements and disagreements, and good days and bad days. When you put two people from different backgrounds with different ideas, feelings, and expectations together, you simply can't expect everything to be wonderful all of the time. While some marriages have very serious problems that can only be solved by intense focus and even therapy, most marriages simply become stale or uninteresting. It is important to reflect on exactly what is causing any conflict or uneasiness in a marriage before acting on it. In a great many marriages, the excitement and take my breath away feelings are fading, or they are even gone. It doesn't mean that the love is gone. Love sometimes needs a little stimulation in order to revisit and maintain the feelings we all crave and yearn for. That stimulation is called romance. Many people mistake a marriage that seems to be ordinary or unexceptional as lacking love. It simply isn't the case. Most marriages do not lack love, but they do lack romance. Love is easy and peaceful, while romance is what makes a relationship hot and arousing. Every single person on earth, in any type of relationship, desires passion and romance in his or her life. Unfortunately, there are a few things about romance most people don't understand. The most common problem in creating romance in a relationship is that people simply don't know how to do it. Other times, people are fixed in cultural classifications, and their partners are unable to appreciate them for their own special and unique qualities. Ultimately, some people have simply given up on their search for romance. In a time where everything is convenient and available almost at the touch of a button, the effort of romance seems as if it takes a good deal of effort. It is very possible to take some old-fashioned romantic ideas and make them work in a modern world, while maintaining the genuine intention behind each thought and act. Romance today can be filled with unique ideas, creativity, and passion. Romance is simply the way you express your love for another person. It is vital to keeping love fresh, exciting, and alive. Without romance, love can be tiresome, and even worse. The expression of love through romance keeps it alive, fun, and worthwhile. Romance is only true, though, when carried out with no ulterior motives. The only reason romance should be initiated is an attempt to show love and appreciation. Romance with true intentions is when you just want to show your mate that you are thinking about them and that they matter enough to make the effort to bring your love to life through action. Romance is more like artistic creation as opposed to an exact science. Those who tend to feel competitive in almost everything they do will need to check that attitude at the door when initiating romance. Love and romance should not be considered a contest that should be outdone time and again. It should be considered a cooperative activity. While love and romance take two in order to work, you can be extremely romantic while still keeping your individuality. Love and romance make perfect partners and can make you and your partner perfect companions as well. Understanding the beautiful simplicity of love. Love is a wonderfully simple concept, but it is never easy. Love and romance work together, hand in hand. Romance is when you show your spouse, in your own special way, how much you love her or him without ulterior motives. You introduce romance between you and your partner to show that there is love in your relationship. You express your love through appreciation and in showing him or her that you have been thinking about them and your love. Romance and love is about selfless giving for the pure joy of making your marriage a happy union. Love can never be expected to be perfect. Although some people might come close to perfect love, it is impossible to achieve. While love is a perfect feeling, humans are imperfect and cannot enjoy the perfection of love without flaws. It doesn't matter, though. Imagine how boring a perfect love would be. Keep in mind that love is never about perfection, and it should only be about love. Romance isn't without its imperfections either. You will have hits and misses with romance. What works for one person may not work for another. Romance should be simply about love, and it is important to remember that, especially when you experience one of those misses. When it comes to the emotional needs involved with love, men and women tend to be far more similar than they are different. When it comes to sex, that's where you'll begin to see the noticeable differences between men and women. Every human being is a complex combination of both physical and psychological characteristics. The closer you move towards the sexual end of things, the more noticeable the differences between men and women will be. When you take a look at the emotional needs of both men and women, they become far more similar. When you approach romance, you cannot approach it as if it is a science or some task that can be controlled or predicted. Romance is an art form that should be expressed as creatively as possible. Romance can be simple or it can be outrageously outrageous. When you enter into a relationship and intend to make romance a strong part of that relationship, you need to make sure that you have an open mind, a creative nature, or that you have access to excellent resources that allow you to borrow from other people's creative genius. Love is something two people have to work at together. You need to be able to set any competitive nature aside and truly enjoy what you are able to give as well as what you receive. Love is something two people have to work at together. You need to be able to set any competitive nature aside and truly enjoy what you are able to give as well as what you receive. If you are always trying to outdo what your spouse has done, or even what you have previously done as far as romantic attempts, you will eventually become frustrated and fall flat on your face. That's not very romantic. Romance should be personal and never feel forced or as if part of any bargain. Love should be given freely and accepted freely, without conditions or guarantees. Any other expressions of love are doomed to hurt feelings and ultimately failure. Everyone has the potential to be romantic. You simply need to find your own romantic within. Appreciating the romantic within. While jumping headfirst into romance mode is fun and exciting, after a while it will start to become stale, just like a relationship can. Being romantic can always be fresh and fun as long as the couple understands what the motives are behind the romance and the underlying intentions. Understanding romance is the most important part of being romantic. When you decide that you want to begin being romantic, you usually take it slow and carefully consider what your partner likes and prefers when it comes to gifts, actions, and gestures. Each romantic expression should have a significant meaning behind it. How you are going to be romantic is far more important than why you are going to be romantic. The process of how you are going to be romantic generally encompasses the why in a much bigger way and is far more effective in conveying any message. When you first met your spouse, you most likely experienced the crush or puppy love phase of your relationship. While you may experience moments of similar feelings, it is almost impossible to recreate that feeling after spending years together. However, you can always have passion with your spouse. Wouldn't you agree that passion is much more desirable than puppy love? When you hear people talking about relationships, you often hear them mention the word chemistry. Why is it that people value chemistry with another person over compatibility? If you think about it, compatibility coupled with romance equals passion. Would you prefer basic chemistry or passion in your relationship? When you look at your partner and you consider being romantic, try not to look too deeply into his or her gender. Gender biasing can really deflate a wonderful intention, especially when it comes to romance. Respect your spouse as the unique individual that he or she is and never allow stereotypes to enter into your romantic intentions. Never point out what you are doing, though. It will be noticed on some level by your spouse. Not only will it be noticed, but it will also be greatly appreciated. You need to remember that no one is perfect, especially when it comes to matters of the heart. This includes romance. You are not and will never be an expert at any point. You will, however, learn and improve as time goes on. Your spouse will teach you things through reactions and suggestions as long as you pay attention. It is worth all the time and effort, as life passes by too quickly, not to be a hopeless romantic. No matter how many years you've been living with the same person, you may think that they don't want romance, but it's just not the case. Everyone wants to have a tremendously rewarding and romantic relationship. It's not an exaggeration to include every single person on the planet. The way in which romance is carried out is usually what makes each relationship unique and sometimes even a challenge. Everything worthwhile takes a little bit of work. But what is more worthwhile than a lasting romance with your spouse? You'll discover that being a romantic makes both of you happier than most other people. You may be a victim of believing what truly are romance myths. These myths can be very dangerous in a relationship over time, and they tend to breed resentment. Make sure you know the difference between truth and myth. It might just be the change you need to point you in the right romantic direction. Battling romance myths. The institution of marriage is surrounded by a number of myths, stories, and advice freely offered by people on a daily basis. Unfortunately, many people listen to and believe these pieces of so-called wisdom to the point where it doesn't help their marriage and it only hinders its growth. Many of the myths regarding relationships are incredibly damaging, and it is unfortunate that they are such common beliefs. Once you understand why certain bits of advice or information can be regarded as myths, you can break through what could be blocking the growth of your marriage. In fact, you may actually learn to appreciate your spouse and your role in your marriage even more. Sensationalist television, magazines, and talk radio have been key players when it comes to fueling any belief that there is a battle between the sexes happening. While there are definitely some physical and psychological differences, they are not enough to earn the term battle as a description. When you allow yourself to consider any kind of battle between the sexes, you risk grouping all men or all women into a certain category, and that leads to stereotyping. Once you recognize that your partner is a unique individual with a number of positive attributes, you can shed the thought that there should be any type of conflict between the two of you. Any thought of a battle or conflict only leads to lack of communication, misunderstandings, and discourages growth in any relationship. "Nice guys finish last" is one of the worst possible sayings floating around today. Whoever thought of that and actually uttered those words, I believe it was Leo DeRocher, must have been feeling truly low and full of self-pity, because there simply cannot be any other explanation. Nice guys never finish last. They may have a longer and harder road sometimes, but it isn't often that you see the bullies and jerks finishing first. If they aren't, who is? Well, it's the nice guys. But they are so nice and gracious, you don't hear them bragging about it. It is also important to note that the word nice doesn't mean weak or effeminate in any way. Nice means socially or conventionally correct, refined or virtuous, and is not at all negative in any way. Nice is not another word for pushover or spineless. Nice is as close to a perfect man as you can come, and they always end up first in line. Romance is all you need in order to save your relationship is a wonderfully optimistic thought, but not quite accurate. If simple romance were enough to save a marriage, it would be running wonderfully rampant throughout the world today. Unfortunately, it takes more than simple romance. If you truly feel love for your spouse and you are expressing it through romance, then it will save your marriage. If you are trying to use romance to buy some time or to placate your spouse, then you're only buying time or placating your spouse. Your time as a married couple is most likely limited and should be attended to immediately by a professional. Battling more romance myths. Sometimes holding on to the myths and old-fashioned views of relationships and marriage are all that hold couples back from having a truly wonderful, fulfilling, and happy relationship. It is important to recognize your spouse as his or her own special individual with so much to offer you and your relationship, if you love, support, and respect your partner. Encouraging your partner through support, understanding, and appreciation are crucial to breaking through stereotypes and the myths that surround relationships between men and women. Working through and dismissing that type of information as old-fashioned, irrelevant, and flat-out wrong can open up doors in your marriage you didn't even know were closed. When things become tense between you and your partner, keep in mind some of the stereotypes you might be clinging to and work to dispel them from your psyche. For example, if one of you or both of you believe that romance is the best way to hide or disguise your faults, it simply isn't the case. Someone who is not a nice person doesn't miraculously change because they present their spouse with flowers. That spouse still isn't a nice person. Romantic gestures may disguise some faults for a short time, but a person's true self always comes through. If you are realistic about who you are and your expectations of each other, then romance can work wonders to improve your relationship. If you give them an inch, they'll take a mile, and if you married them, you most likely would have seen it by now. There isn't any truth to this particular saying, and it only sets us up to be suspicious of someone who really hasn't done anything in order to earn our suspicion. If you give a little bit consistently, you will be satisfying your partner, and they won't need that extra. If you don't ever give, or give so infrequently that your efforts are forgotten, your spouse has every right to demand a mile from you. Give him or her an inch and enjoy the journey down the rest of the mile together. If you think that once you marry someone that you can change him or her, you are in for a rude awakening. You cannot change a person, yet you can make an impact on how they may see things. You can help them to adjust to new or unfamiliar ways of thinking, and you can always resort to manipulation. But nothing will change or even fix your spouse. Never manipulate or push your partner into a direction he or she resists. You may be the one who needs to alter his or her way of thinking or viewing things. You may be able to do that on your own or require the help of a therapist in order to show you the skills you need for better understanding and acceptance of you and your spouse. If you feel there are problems between you and your spouse due to personality conflicts, try working together to learn how to express thoughts and feelings better and more productively. If you are both in love, you will find the romance in there somewhere. The best way to start is usually at the beginning with the basics. Getting back to the basics of love and romance. Almost every love story has the potential to begin as if it were a fairy tale. Once upon a time, two people fell passionately in love, and their love was unlike any others before theirs. Relationship beginnings are wonderful, and they can experience a rebirth with a wedding, honeymoon, and the exciting first year of marriage. Once a couple begins to grow and their lives change, with jobs, children, and activities, and other commitments, the love and romance becomes more difficult to attend to. Sometimes love and romance seem to be lost altogether. This destiny is not unavoidable if you want to rekindle the passion or simply bring it to a new level by becoming a hopeless romantic. When you want to ignite the passion in your relationship, but you aren't sure what you need to do, the best place to begin is at the beginning. Think about the things that you used to do for your partner at the beginning of your relationship. If you don't remember or never tried to be a true romantic, don't worry. It's not difficult, and once you begin, you will find that you will get your own new ideas after a while. Most new relationships or new beginnings rely on the little things to show love and affection. Be sure to remember special couple days, like Valentine's Day, anniversaries, and even the date you met, if possible. Be sure to send a meaningful gift or just a dozen roses and a box of chocolates to celebrate your feelings for your partner. Women can do exactly the same thing for men here. Not many men can resist candy. You may not consider yourself to be a writer, but writing your partner a long love letter with your thoughts about how you feel for the other person is one of the most touching ways to spark romance. If you aren't comfortable writing a letter, consider making lists about what you love the most about your partner. Lists can be about the things they do that make you laugh, what they do for you that you appreciate, how they make you feel inside, how beautiful or handsome they are, and other very personal but attentive details. Call your partner and talk softly and lovingly. If he or she isn't able to answer the phone, leave loving messages on their voicemail or answering machine. talk dirty when you know that he or she can't return the same conversation on the other end. Sometimes couples feel more comfortable trying to bring romance into their relationship by bestowing gifts on their partner. While classics like flowers, candy, and perfume or cologne are almost always successful gifts, try giving something different. Make plans to go see every romantic movie that comes to the theater during the year. Bring home a bottle of champagne to celebrate even the tiniest accomplishment he or she has had. Randomly send romantic and/or humorous greeting cards to his or her workplace, or hide them under the bed pillows at home. These suggestions are simple ideas to get you started in your effort to bring romance and love to a new level in your marriage. You may have your own ideas, and those are most likely better than anything offered here. Once you open the door to romance in your marriage, and you begin to build a foundation for future romance, you are ready to move to even more creative levels of romance. When entering into the world of romance with your spouse, you should always keep in mind that something you may find romantic may not be romantic to your partner. This is often due to differences between the preferences and thought processes of men and women. Struggle of the sexes. While most people acknowledge that opposites attract, they are also quick to point out that men and women generally tend to be different in a number of ways. Although this is basically true, it isn't an excuse to not have romance in your marriage. Men and women can both be romantic with their spouse once they understand the likes and dislikes of their partner. Sometimes it just takes a little patience, attention, and effort on your part to get things going and to make romance happen. For the husbands that have no idea where to begin with their wives, you can always start with a day at the mall. Prepare a shopping list of specific items or stores you know she either frequents or would enjoy receiving a gift from. If you still feel quite clueless as to what you buy your wife, here is your own shopping list guaranteed to thrill her. Begin at a bath shop and buy her lotion, bath gel, and/or powder. Next, visit a lingerie shop. If you are unsure of your wife's size, ask the employees for help. There's no need to be embarrassed, and they are more than happy to assist you in your search. Locate a fine and reputable jewelry store. If you are unsure of your wife's ring size, stick to a necklace, bracelet, or brooch. Stop by a liquor store and pick up her favorite bottle of wine or a bottle of champagne for no particular reason other than to celebrate each other. Your next stop should be the flower shop, where you can pick out her favorite flowers or simply a rose. Finally, you will need a card to accompany all of your purchases. If you prefer, you can make your own card or write a personalized love letter instead. Make sure that all of her gifts are wrapped separately and enjoy the pleasure you both will get from your efforts. Now for the wives who want to do something extra special and romantic for their husbands, you can either buy him a romantic card or write him a personal love letter before sealing the envelope and sealing it with a kiss. Make sure you use the reddest lipstick you have for the kiss and then mail it to him. For a variation on this idea, spray a card or note with your perfume. Try and do your best not to become a choice between him and his passions, whether they are sports, computers, etc. He was once a huge fan of yours, and you simply have to remind him of that and make it worth his while to be your fan once again. If you have trouble understanding your man in your relationship, take the time to discover what it is about him that makes him who he is. Robert Bly and Rachel Snyder have some wonderfully entertaining and insightful books to assist you on this subject. Not only will you be able to understand your husband a little better, but you will also be able to increase your intimacy level and trust as a result of your efforts. Various qualities and differences among the sexes. There's a very famous book available at any bookstore, online book retailer, or your local library that is worth a look at some point. It is called Men Are From Mars and Women Are From Venus by John Gray. The book is a wonderful attempt to explain the natural differences between men and women. The author's point in his book is to basically help men and women to acknowledge, understand, and accept these differences before they can move on and enjoy fuller, happier relationships. Mr. Gray offers a spirited look at these differences that are intended to explain these differences so that men and women might be able to adjust their thinking so that they find it easier to understand intentions and meaning behind thought processes and actions. The first step in understanding the differences between men and women is to acknowledge that there are, in fact, differences between the sexes, especially in the way that they communicate with each other. Men simply do not think the way that women do, and women do not think the way that men do. For example, if a woman declares that she would like to go out to dinner and a movie, her husband would most likely not think of her idea as a romantic one. He is more likely to immediately think about how much a night out will cost and become stressed about it. When a man gives a woman risque lingerie, he is thinking about how wonderful she will look in it. A woman is more likely to think that he is trying to get her to look like a prostitute. The use of the word romance can be quite slippery as well, with a woman using romance to refer to love, while a man usually infers sex when he refers to romance. Be careful and clarify intentions before things go too far. When you are buying lingerie for your husband, keep in mind that it is for him. You are buying it to thrill and please him. Choose colors that you know he will like. Studies show that while women prefer pastel-colored lingerie, men prefer to see women in red and black lingerie. Make sure that the lingerie is truly chosen for your spouse and not just what makes you happy. Women have a natural habit of complaining that is and has been referred to for decades as nagging. Women need to stop nagging, no matter what the cause of the nag. Men tend to be quite judgmental. Women do not want to be judged or corrected. They also resent any type of conversation that resembles a lecture. She doesn't want or need it, and will end up resenting you for it. Instead of focusing on the conflict of nature between men and women, focus on the wonderful attributes each partner has to bring into the relationship. Talk more, listen better, and make fewer assumptions. Also, try to appreciate your spouse for more than just his or her differences. Appreciate him or her for the good things that they bring to your marriage. Similarities among the sexes. While there is no arguing that men and women have very real differences, it doesn't give you an excuse to ignore all of the wonderful similarities men and women share. For example, love is not an emotion owned or mastered by a single sex. Love is for both sexes to experience, share, and enjoy. If love is not for a single sex, then neither is romance. Romance is for both men and women. In fact, romance cannot work without the two sexes working together at it. Men and women may have different ways of thinking and reacting, but underneath it all, men and women both have the same needs. Relationships and traditional gender roles have changed drastically over the past century. While a wife would once never consider sending her husband flowers at work, it is a common gesture today. In fact, most men would feel comfortable and flattered if they were to receive flowers at work. Flowers are also appreciated when delivered to the home. Women tend to have a hard time thinking about men as romantic and sentimental beings. They should keep in mind that a man wrote some of the greatest love stories of all time in Romeo and Juliet. Nicholas Sparks is one of the most romantic authors of today, and he, too, is a man. Some of the most talented dancers with the lightest feet have been men like Gene Kelly and Fred Astaire. Try to look at any differences between you and your spouse as personality differences instead of differences between the sexes. While it is easy to lump men and women into gender-specific categories, it would be unfair and completely inaccurate. Not all women are sensitive and emotional. Not all men are aggressive and logical. While these thoughts might seem to be generally true, the special and unique qualities in your particular spouse are the reason why you fell in love with him or her in the first place. Try to sit down in a quiet and private area with your spouse. Talk about how and why you fell in love with him or her. Offer him or her the opportunity to do the same for you. The only rule is that you both have to be very, very specific. Make a mental note of how many qualities are gender specific and how many are not. You might find yourself surprised at the results. Your next job is to keep in mind your own answers and work at supporting and enjoying those qualities in your partner on a daily basis. The key to recognizing differences between you and your spouse is to not focus on them. If you focus on them or place too much emphasis on them, you will create conflict that needn't be there. Look at what that particular quality brings to the relationship or how it can be a positive influence. Use romance to connect you as lovers and spouses, as well as a tool to accept and appreciate each other's differences. Opposites attract. We've all heard the expression that opposites attract, Heck, Paula Abdul even made a song dedicated to such a phenomenon. While opposites can seem to have the biggest challenges ahead of them when they get married, they also have the most opportunities for love and romance. People who embrace romance and actually admit that they enjoy romance are more likely to be successfully married to their opposite. It just goes to show you how powerful romance can be in any marriage. Every marriage experiences problems and even misunderstandings, from small tiffs to shouting matches. And the reason for this is often because both spouses are not able to acknowledge, recognize, and appreciate their differences or the principle of balancing opposites. Everything is intended to be able to work with and often balance its opposite. Life is full of opposites that complement each other, like man and woman, happy and sad, funny and serious, give and take, as well as life and death. Opposites offer insight into the magic of how life is balanced. If you begin to see your spouse as your equivalent on the opposite side of the scale of life, you should find that you have a new appreciation for his or her individuality. Try seeing everything you experience in your marriage as complementary experiences or behaviors. For instance, instead of using your differences with your spouse as a reason for conflict, try considering them as an important part of the person you love and celebrate them. While the opposite traits may seem to stand out, you undoubtedly have some common traits you share with your spouse. Find strength with your spouse because of your similarities. Take each day with your spouse and live it to the fullest. At the same time, it is a wonderful idea to make your memories a part of what makes your romance special. If you love reading books, buy some more, but make them about something that your spouse is interested in. He or she may never read the book, but you will have, and you can share all kinds of thoughts and ideas that you may not have been able to before. At the same time, stop relying on books that tell you how to improve your marriage. You already have all that you need without them. You and your spouse are already there. Make sure you aren't holding anything back in your relationship. Each partnership tends to have an individual who would rather bury their feelings than express them and possibly cause conflict or wounded feelings. It is absolutely all right to express how you feel as long as your words are chosen carefully. Never take on an accusative tone and always be sure you emphasize what you are saying is how you feel. You are married to your best friend. If you don't treat him or her like they are your best friend already, it's time to start right now. On the other hand, sometimes it might be fun to act like he or she is a complete stranger to spice things up. Imagine a chance to get to know one another all over again. Part of getting to know each other often includes assessing your roles in your relationship. Learning about how your partner feels regarding your role in your marriage can be an enlightening and educational experience. It is also an excellent tool that can help both of you grow. Getting a perfect score for your relationship. You probably have a good idea of where you and your spouse are in your relationship, or if you don't, it's time to find out. Consider thinking about your relationship, write down where you believe your relationship could use some improvement, and talk to your spouse about what you have been thinking and feeling. Achieving an exceptional relationship is not easy, but it is an attainable goal. People who have wonderfully rewarding relationships are loving and giving people. This is a lifestyle that is available to every couple that is willing to work towards such a goal. When you are looking to have an outstanding relationship with your spouse, you will benefit in more ways than you can imagine. You will be more able to understand your loving relationship in ways that you never thought possible, and it helps you to act in ways that satisfy both you and your partner, as well as nurture both of you as a couple. An exceptional relationship is one where you and your partner have the best intimate relationship possible, where you are both faithful, passionate, committed to growth, romantic, and fascinating. You both consistently work at making your love grow, and although not perfect, your relationship is one that you wouldn't trade for anything else in the world. So how do you arrive at such an existence with your spouse? You must dedicate yourself to achieving excellence while you work hard, play hard, and you both work on your relationship skills together. As simple as it sounds, you both have to live how you love each other each and every day. Great relationships don't just happen. They arise as a result of work, work, and work. You need to be creative and working together at creating the relationship into one life you can both share together. Your relationship with your spouse is very individual, and only you both know what you want as far as a life together. You are in charge of making your rules and expectations for your individual relationship. This type of direction you can make for your marriage is a wonderful concept in the way people view relationships. You are able to make your relationship into exactly what you want it to be. You are in charge of your goals and in meeting your own standards. You have the unique knowledge that allows you to create a relationship out of the values you treasure the most, like honesty, faith, commitment, creativity, flexibility, and equality. With this knowledge, as well as the desire to create such a wonderfully romantic and loving desire, you can create a relationship that is not only fulfilling and rewarding, but enviable as well. When you can center your attention on the behaviors in your marriage and not on the personalities, you can focus your attention on setting goals instead of placing blame. This method helps you to set, reach, and maintain your goals in order to have the marriage most couples only dream about. Relationship evaluation. Everyone dreaded report card day in school, and if you are dreading making your own relationship report card, then you need to buckle down and study. When you rank all of the aspects of your relationship between you and your spouse, you need to score in the high 90s to achieve an A+. Consider creating a relationship report card with your spouse and watch the awakening you will both experience. When you try to complete your relationship report card, it should not turn into a blame game. It should open the lines of communication and offer some invaluable insight into your relationship as to where you need changes and improvements. When you consider how you want to grade your partner and yourself, it is a good idea to have some preset guidelines as to what each grade means. For example, an A might mean that your partner isn't perfect, but obviously excelling. It could also mean that your partner is loving, attentive, enthusiastic, and satisfying. A B could stand for a partner who is always trying, better than most, and consistently works on improvement. A C might mean average or acceptable. C's always indicate plenty of room for improvement. D's and F's should be reserved for unhappy situations or even hopeless ones. D's indicate never hopeless, while F's require more than just a relationship evaluation. If you find that you and your spouse have areas with a D or an F, you need to focus on why you are giving or receiving those grades and commit to some kind of action in order to change and improve that grade. It might involve a commitment from both spouses, but if both are willing to work at it, the grade is already moving higher. When you begin working on your relationship report card, it should be graded the same way your school papers were graded, with a number grade, 80%, 50%, 95%, and so on. Grade your partner and yourself in areas like affection, ability to resolve conflict, attitude, commitment, communication skills, consideration level, thinking as a couple, creativity, sensitivity, flexibility, generosity, friendship, and gift-giving skills. Once you've completed that list, continue to evaluate your honesty levels, listening skills, household management skills, patience, lovemaking, romance abilities and practice, playfulness, self-esteem, self-awareness, sense of humor, empathy, tolerance, and spontaneity. If you feel that there are any other areas relevant to your particular relationship, feel free to add and evaluate at your discretion. When you and your spouse are grading each other, be sure to both participate in grading. You can work out your own particulars, but make sure you both have a say in both of your grades. Compare and talk about your grades and why your partner believes you deserve a particular grade. This includes the good grades, too. You'll be surprised at how your partner sees your relationship, and you'll have invaluable insight into how he or she sees your role in the relationship. Just because you may not have earned an A+ in one area doesn't mean that you can't celebrate. Pat yourself and your partner on the back for anything over a B, and talk about ways you can improve on any C's and D's. Once you've completed your evaluations, you can move on to altering or improving certain behaviors. Sometimes you may be better off thinking instead of acting, or even better, thinking before acting. Thinking versus acting. Clichés are a dime a dozen, but there are two that are appropriate when it comes to relationships and romance. Those two comments are, it's the thought that counts, and actions speak louder than words. These two concepts are unique in that they are both true when it comes to any relationship, and they also must be somehow balanced in order to work properly. Each action or thought truly depends on the two individuals that are involved, as well as the particular situation they find themselves in. On one hand, the gesture or gift that makes an impact, while on the other hand, it's the thought or the meaning or the intention that makes an impact. Along with the thought and action, there are many other layers involved in what makes any romantic effort in a relationship work or not work. First, it is important to stop stereotyping each other, trying to make assumptions about what he or she thinks, feeling threatened by their position at work, intellectually or otherwise, ignoring feelings, and so on. Secondly, it is important to be yourself and accept your partner for who he or she is. Communicate with each other while really listening. Always practice good manners with each other, even though you may be comfortable enough to pass wind in front of each other. There is no need to let it all go. Make your relationship your first priority over everything else in your life. Stop making jokes about male or female behavior or conditions. While it may be funny for the moment, it can become part of how we view each other or how we fear our partners view us. Don't assume anything that you aren't 100% sure about when it comes to your spouse. He or she will most likely prove you wrong. Don't act as if every action was a huge sacrifice. A martyr can suck a relationship dry. Offer each other trust, hope, the benefit of the doubt, and try to understand how he or she feels before assuming any position. Sometimes it's best to begin slowly and build up to the more complicated aspects of growing a relationship with anyone. All it takes is one successful step in the right direction, and you and your spouse will be hungry for more. Cuddle up together without the television on, the radio on. Turn the phones off, and if you have kids, put them to bed early. Take him or her to a special tree and carve your initials in together. Take the time to do something you normally wouldn't do that he or she is sure to enjoy. Men love to have their feet massaged, and most women don't know that. Sit him or her down in a chair, place their feet in a hot bin of water, and wash and massage their feet. Dry them off, and go about your day as you normally would. Try to find ways to provide your love with something he or she can live without, but truly enjoys. Does he or she love a white Christmas, but you live in an area where snow doesn't fall, or the weather isn't cooperating? Find a way to fill your lawn with snow, or artificial snow, so that you are the one giving them a white Christmas. Once you consider introducing romance to your relationship, you may realize that your marriage hasn't come first in your life. It is important that your relationship be the top priority in your life in order to be successful. Relationship rationalizations. So many relationships come in second, third, or even worse to the many distractions in our daily lives. Unfortunately, these distractions are allowing too many marriages to end in divorce, or a couple simply coexist for years longing for happiness and fulfillment. It simply doesn't have to be this way. It's time to take a look at what is really important and what will matter in the long run. Once your job or other commitments are gone, all you'll have left is an empty marriage or an empty home to face every day. It's time to stop making excuses and find the time to romance your spouse starting today. Some women truly believe that men aren't generally capable of being romantic. No matter how masculine a guy is, he is capable of romance. It is just another excuse for people to let their relationships slide. Romance leads to happy relationships, while relationships without romance lead to loneliness or even worse. All men are and can show that they are romantic. So can all women. When you envision romance, you probably think about a great deal of materialistic exchanging happening between you and your spouse. Romance isn't about what is tangible or how much you spent. Romance is about the thought and intention behind every gesture you make. As long as the thought is behind your efforts, you will have romance. improving your relationship with better companionship, sex, and attention is very romantic alone. If you've decided to be romantic, you have one chance to forget about your commitment. Just one chance, and then that's it. From then on, it's an excuse, a bad one at that, and you will do more damage to your relationship than you thought possible from neglecting your spouse. If you are constantly forgetting, you are displaying behavior that can only be interpreted as your spouse simply isn't that important to you. Procrastination is the archenemy of romance. While your career is and should be important, your spouse should be more important. Imagine sitting on your front porch in your golden years while looking back at everything you've accomplished, as well as any regrets you might have. Do you really think you'll be wishing you had spent more time working? For the belligerent spouses out there, it is more likely crossed your mind that you don't have to be romantic because you shouldn't have to prove your love to your spouse. Being married and bringing romance into your relationship isn't about proving anything. Romance with your spouse is about showing how much you appreciate and love him or her. Don't drag your heels when it comes to being romantic. Putting it off can become just as bad as never doing it at all. And the habit is quite an easy one to fall into. Consider the fact that you don't know how long you and your spouse will be lucky enough to have each other. Whether he or she will become deceased or they leave your procrastinating butt, you simply don't have the time to put off making your marriage an incredibly loving and romantic partnership. Romance isn't about being told what to do or what someone wants. Romance comes from the heart. You have a heart, and therefore are capable of romance. A creative romantic lives in you. Why is it that so many people believe that they don't have time or take the initiative to be romantic? Maybe most people don't believe that they are creative enough to be romantic. Everyone is creative. The definition of being creative is having the ability or power to create. The word create offers a much broader definition than most people accept when it comes to the process of being able to come up with something original or simply well thought out. Gifts that are considered to be traditionally romantic, like candy and flowers, are wonderful. But sometimes you need something that goes one step further. If your spouse enjoys flowers, you don't have to settle for roses, because they can sometimes become unexciting after a while. Present him or her with something completely original, such as a daisy, or another flower where petals can be counted. Ask him or her to play the childhood game of, they love me, they love me not, and watch them pluck the petals as they go. However, don't allow for the possibility of him or her arriving at the, they love me not. Count the petals before you present the flower to your spouse and trim it so that there is an odd number of petals for the right outcome. Arts and crafts used to be a fun break from the monotony of the school day, but believe it or not, it will come in handy when it comes to creative romantic gestures. Instead of promising that you will love him or her forever, show them. Take a piece of paper, ribbon, or other material you choose and write, I love you, on both sides from end to end. Twist the paper 180 degrees and connect both ends of the paper until you have made what looks like the figure eight. Tape or glue the ends together. You can present your love with a symbol that shows them your love for them is an endless love. Creativity comes in many different forms. Being creative can mean creating an atmosphere. If you want to plan the ultimate romantic evening, but funds are low or you simply don't want to have to leave the house, shut down the electricity and imitate a power outage. It's up to you whether or not you tell him or her. You won't have any distractions or heat, so it is up to both of you to keep the other warm and entertain each other. Maybe romance is on your mind, but he or she is going out of town. Do you know that people on airplanes are typically hopeless romantics? Any flight attendant would be more than happy to make sure that your spouse receives a special present after the flight has left the ground. Simply approach a crew member after he or she boards the plane, and they are usually more than happy to oblige a hopeless romantic like you. You might want to make sure that the gift is unwrapped or keep it to a single rose due to heightened security. Creativity doesn't have to come in the form of gifts every single time. Gestures like getting up and dancing with your spouse when a special song comes on the radio is quite creative and incredibly romantic. Whenever the mood strikes you, allow your creative juices to flow. Sometimes you may find that you struggle with ways you can be romantic. You can always have a backup plan or a secondary plan of action. The readied romantic. Although being creative might be something you don't think you have within you, you simply haven't found a way to tap into your creative potential. While you may not know where your particular strengths lie, you can discover what works for you and your spouse, as well as what doesn't work, with a few simple ideas to get you started. Take a large empty jar and use it so that each time you come up with what you think are spectacularly romantic ideas, you can write them down on small separate pieces of paper. Keep writing your ideas down until the jar is full. If your spouse wants to participate in this with you, he or she can add romantic ideas as well. About once a week, one of you must take an idea from the jar, no peeking, and they have to follow through on their selection within the following week. Both spouses should be able to add to the jar at any time. If one spouse or both have a difficult time coming up with romantic ideas on their own, they can think about some of the most romantic movies they've ever seen in order to try and come up with ideas. Another way to get ideas is to watch soap operas. While most of the storylines aren't something anyone wants to have to experience in their lifetime, some of the lines and gestures are incredibly romantic. You can also read a romance novel. They are chock full of what most women fantasize about with a man, and you will have a unique perspective in being able to provide it to your spouse. If you still come up empty, you can check your local library or bookstore and take a look at the hundreds of books filled with all sorts of original romantic ideas. Do you love a challenge? Create your own original search a word or crossword puzzle that contains important events in your lives or things that have special meaning to both of you. You can include things like where you went on your honeymoon, where he or she proposed, private jokes, pet names, favorite songs, favorite time of day, or anything else that makes you think of your spouse. When you feel that your creativity just won't cut it and you want to present your spouse with a gift, it might not be an opportune time to get in the car, go to the store, and take the time to pick up something special. Instead of always waiting until you are approaching a special occasion or you simply need something last minute, why not start picking up little gifts here and there for your spouse and put them away in a secret hiding place to be used later on? You can also save money by shopping for your spouse this way. When you buy items on sale or discounted, when you buy in bulk, or simply when you see something you are sure your spouse would love. You will always be prepared for any type of special occasion or no particular occasion at all. Romance is the perfect opportunity for couples to show how they love and appreciate each other. When something is that important to you, it deserves to be celebrated. Celebrate your relationship. If you are spending time looking for ways in which you can improve your relationship, you obviously love and care for your partner and what you want to have together. Start your changes by celebrating your relationship. Celebrate the joy of having met that one very special person. Find joy in the wonderful things that click about you and your spouse, and celebrate what you are committed to building together. You can celebrate any day at any time, and you can also celebrate by surprising your spouse. On your next birthday, celebrate your spouse and how he or she makes your existence better by presenting him or her with a gift. He or she will be so surprised that you might see a tear or two of joy fall. Start paying attention to what he or she likes. Really listen to what your spouse says. Pay attention to the items he or she says he would like to try someday and get it for them. Don't give it to your spouse immediately and put the item away for a period of time. The period of time is up to you. It could be a week or it could be a month. When you think that he or she will no longer remember discussing the item with you, present it to them as a gift. Take over a chore or a daily task for your spouse without letting them know about your intentions. Mow the lawn, wash the car, cook and clean up from meals or clean the house. Do something substantial for him or her. If you find that he or she loved having the break from a particular task, do it over and over again as often as you can. One of the most recognizable symbols of a celebration is a balloon. Fill your car with balloons and take them home to him or her. Fill the living room before he or she gets home from work. Make sure you have some balloons marked with your names and hearts on them, and some should have personal messages written as well. Begin the celebration of your love today. Start celebrating each major and minor holiday with your spouse. Begin with New Year's Eve and do it big. Go to New York City and go to Times Square. If that's as big as you can think, Valentine's Day should be done as lavishly as possible. On the 4th of July, plan to attend the most extravagant fireworks display you can find, or plan on making fireworks of your own at home. Always celebrate each other's birthdays and do it with flair. Your anniversary should be a special day and celebrated with an expensive bottle of your favorite drink. Get dressed up on Halloween as your favorite fantasy characters and role play for the entire evening. Celebrate any and every day you want by staying home from work and playing in bed. Celebrate as often or infrequently as you want, but make sure you take the time to play, surprise each other, and celebrate your relationship. When you celebrate together, live together, and love together, you shouldn't be making notes about who gave how much and how often. Romance is about giving without expectation. Give, give, give. Everyone knows the old sayings about marriage and how everything requires compromise and each partner should give 50%. Well, they are wrong. Everything should not require compromise, or everything will end up turning into a business negotiation and someone will feel that they gave up more than they should have. This leads to resentment, and it doesn't have to. While there are certain situations that may be important enough to you or your spouse to make an issue of that will require compromise, it's time to consider making sacrifices here or there for your spouse. He or she will, of course, be surprised when you do so, but they will also begin doing the same for you out of appreciation for you and your actions. Each partner in a marriage should not be giving 50% all of the time. If you are only giving 50%, you are only doing half as well as you could be doing. If you and your spouse are both giving 100%, you can't go wrong. You are both giving your marriage all your dedication and effort. If you and your spouse are planning on only meeting each other halfway, you will only be successful half of the time, or maybe even less. Romance isn't really romance when it's convenient for you or your spouse. Your romantic gestures on romantic days like Valentine's Days or birthdays can only be considered romantic if you go out of your way to be romantic throughout the rest of the year. You don't have to spend money in order to be romantic either. Begin offering to stop on the way home in case he or she would like you to pick something up. Never allow anyone else to greet him or her at the airport no matter what time the flight arrives. Start getting up and taking care of housework or even the kids before he or she has the chance to ask you to. Instead of thinking about being romantic, simply do it. Make the decision that you are going to fall in love with your spouse and simply do it. If you spend too much time thinking about it, you will find yourself the victim of self-sabotage. You will focus on faults, hurts, and other unimportant distractions that will stop you from reaching your goal. You don't need books or a professional to help you with this process. You simply make the decision and you do it. In order to become romantic by just doing it, you will find that listening is your best tool. By listening to him or her with more than just your ears, but with your eyes and heart as well, you will see that there is so much more to discover about this incredible person you are committed to. Not only will you find that they are offering all sorts of clues and tips on how to be more romantic in your relationship, you will also find opportunities to offer support and fall in love all over again. Giving never has a limit attached. Large, medium, and best of all, small gestures are good enough as long as they come from the heart. A little goes a long way. Relationships are never always easy. It is normal to hit some bumps in the road, or to even have long stretches where you and your partner have a hard time connecting. Couples who are lucky enough to seem to get along more often than not have probably discovered a little secret early on in their marriage. That secret is to show love and affection in little ways often, not always in big ways when things seem to be going badly or when an apology is in order. Imagine stopping on the way home from work and picking wildflowers from alongside the road for your spouse. She may have had a difficult day on the job the kids were trying her patience, or both of you simply seem to have lost your intimacy lately. If you were to walk in the door with a fistful of wildflowers you took the time to select just for her on the way home, you will have broken the surrounding atmosphere with love and consideration. You both have the opportunity to start fresh with that one small yet powerful gesture. If you are going out of town or simply feeling like ships passing in the night because of kids, commitments, or work, find a suncatcher, charm, or porcelain figure in the shape of a star or a shooting star. Wrap the trinket in a small gift box and fold a note on top of it that says, "Wish you were here," and place it in his or her travel bag or even in a briefcase or purse. When he or she finds it and knows that you are missing them and thought enough to share that sentiment, it will stir emotions that may not have been awakened in some time. In order to change tedious or tired routines or to inspire intimacy, you might be surprised at how little effort is required. Tape a note on the television that says, "Wouldn't you rather turn me on instead?" If he or she is enjoying a good book, remove the bookmark and replace it with a note that says, "I'll bet you'll never guess where I've hidden your bookmark." Remember the small things you used to do when you first got together that would make your heart flutter and put a twinkle in your eye? Do them again. When you go shopping, for a walk, or just sitting together watching TV, hold hands, link arms, or put your arm around her. Softly whisper, "Hey," into his or her ear and gaze lovingly into each other's eyes. If he or she wants to know what you are doing, simply say that you are amazed at how much you love them. These simple, small acts really go far when it comes to sparking a little romance in your marriage. They can break the monotony of a relationship or help your partner to feel appreciated and loved. You can expect to feel the same in return. Just as you shouldn't have reciprocal expectations when you give, you should be able to recognize that your partner is always giving you something in return just by being with you. He or she is your balance. The rules of romance. Romance is sort of like a wonderful way in which people can balance each other. This can come about in a lot of different ways that are probably already occurring in your relationship. You simply don't know how to see it yet. Think about what has changed about you since you married your spouse. You can probably say that quite a bit has changed. Now think about how much hasn't changed since you got married. You can probably say that quite a bit hasn't changed as well. Your spouse, your love, and your romance offer the opportunity to balance your relationship beautifully. You may feel threatened in some way when you think about surrendering completely to your love for your spouse. Remember that you can always lose yourself in that love without risking losing your individuality. You can also allow yourself and even embrace change without losing what it is about you that makes you unique. Compromise is always possible without having to compromise who you are. Growth is always possible, and it never has to mean growing apart. You and your spouse are capable of having disagreements without arguments. You can allow yourself to experience emotion and feelings without losing control of yourself. Trust is essential in any relationship, especially a marriage. You can give it to your partner without the fear of losing anything. You can open up to him or her without the fear of being judged. It is possible to keep the passion alive in your marriage for the duration of your lifetime. You can remain a responsible adult while indulging in your inner child, and the only time you are truly known is in your intimate, long-term relationship, your marriage. Your lover cannot know who you truly are unless you open up your heart completely. You cannot be a participant in a loving relationship without being vulnerable. Being intimate always comes with a risk, even if you are with your spouse, and you must be willing to face that risk. Both you and your spouse need to make sure that you create a supportive environment, or else you will never be able to share your feelings freely with each other. Spontaneity and control don't work well together. In fact, they can't work together at all. If control is an issue for either you and or your spouse, it needs to be addressed. You will never be able to be independent with your spouse unless you are first able to be independent on your own. Dependence is a harmful thing in any relationship, and it must be changed into a healthy dependence. Both spouses need to be open to the fact that neither of you can grow without learning from your mistakes. Once you learn how to forgive yourself, you can learn how to forgive others, and grudges cannot be held. Broken hearts will not heal unless that heart is put at risk again. The point of romance is to grow together in love and intimacy. Love and intimacy can mean a number of different things to different people, and all of them are essential to a healthy relationship. Live together, learn together, grow together, and love together. Continue to learn about your spouse and what makes your relationship work. One of the most common ways that people learn is from their mistakes. Romance mistakes. Being romantic is wonderful fun and especially rewarding. But unfortunately, many people make mistakes we all make in relationships that can simply undo all of the good that has been done by romantic efforts. For instance, every couple has disagreements, and upon occasion, the argument has a definitive outcome. The spouse that was right during the argument has two choices when winning. He or she cannot see it as winning and simply move on, or express understanding as to why there may have been some confusion. Or he or she can gloat and make their spouse feel inferior and possibly humiliated. One works, the moving on one, and one doesn't, the gloating one. Conflict is often unavoidable when two people from two different backgrounds with different beliefs are brought together. If you happen to be the one in a disagreement who doesn't come out as the right one, or you don't get your way, the worst thing you can do is to pout. It's simply childish, not sexy at all, and your partner will most likely have a difficult time finding respect for you as a result. While worry is a natural part of life, try not to let it overwhelm your relationship. Wouldn't you rather focus on much more positive things like romance? If you find that you and your spouse schedule a lot during the week, sit down and try to eliminate some commitments. Don't overschedule any time that you don't have to, including vacations and weekends. Make choices that benefit both you and your spouse. Instead of turning on the television, ask your wife or husband if they would like to play a board game or go for a walk. If you decide to watch television together, never guess at the plot or give away the ending of a movie. Try to support your spouse's authority in front of the children. If you disagree about what was done, wait until you can talk quietly with your spouse and discuss why or how things may have been done differently. He or she can always go back and change their mind, or you may eventually come to support his or her decisions. Make it as much as possible in your relationship about us instead of about you. This doesn't mean that you or your spouse has to sacrifice his or her individuality. It simply means that all decisions and thoughts about the relationship should be about both of your needs instead of your own individual needs. For instance, if you happen to be or sleep with someone who hogs the bed covers, go out and find an extra large blanket so that there's plenty for both to share. Don't make an issue out of it. Make a joke and provide a solution. Show your spouse that you are a loving and mature individual by doing mature and loving things, like never holding grudges or continuously bringing up errors from the past. You can also be a good listener, never interrupt, and wait your turn. And most importantly, don't allow a day to pass by without telling your spouse that you love them. Know what is important in your life. Keep your priorities straight. Acknowledge that your marriage should be the center of your life. Live that way.